Yes. Appreciate if you sing this song. It's another love song for a beautiful lady we all love and adore. This song goes out to sweet, dear chocolate chip cook Mickey. said, but that first record's got a lot of love songs.
Yeah.
We got another love song right now.
We love you!
Now I'm not gonna blame it all on the police, because this shit's been broken 9 times. Only 4 times by the police. Ribs broken by the police. But I ain't complaining, because one of the times I wasn't handcuffed, so I should have been able to defend myself. The difference between them and now, they didn't have cameras back then. It didn't happen. We weren't able to play in LA for years. The police would come, they'd have the taped over. We saw some fucked up shit. Little kids getting their heads bashed in. The people call that the good old days. They weren't there to see this. This is a love song. This is about overcoming and put it together. Fascist pig.
Thank you.
Thank you. Got a question. How many of y'all seen Suicidal before? But you gotta be careful what you say, because people are gonna think that you're saying something you're not saying. It's just a matter of fact. She got Chay fucked up with all that COVID shit. And a lot of people have their thoughts about not the whole situation, but how they were gonna handle it in their lives and how they were going forth. We said, as my dad said, we used being up for red light. But we didn't lose the lessons we learned a long time ago. We're gonna take a little check right now. We got any suicidal motherfuckers here tonight? The one thing I love is we're doing this at Melfest. The next two shows are rock. We're doing metal, then we're doing a punk rock festival, doing all kinds of things, action sports. We're able to play in front of a lot of different people. And that's where it was when I started off, a little kid, and looked up to his brother that was 5 years older and got on a skateboard, emptied out a pool and started skating in it. Dog Townscape's Red Dog. And when you're young, you look up and want to be like my brother who ended up in the Skateboard Hall of Fame. And he said when he got on the skateboard, he didn't know what it meant, but he knew it was changing his life right then. 12 years old, that's a great situation. He's still doing Dogtown 45 some years later. I got on the skateboard, I had that feeling. I go, this is fucking insane. Fuck! I'm gonna fail. But it was so good, I got back on. Get up there going, ow, oh, fuck! So I went to my brother, who's a pro skateboarder, searching knowledge, you know? Except don't search on Google, you find out you died a long time ago or something. But anyhow, ask him, Jim, what's the secret? He said, it's quite simple. When you fall down, get your ass back up! That's skateboarding, that's life.
That's right.
I say this now, I'm not taking it as a bad way, but 5 years ago, Suicidal Tendencies was inducted to the Skateboard Hall of Fame. And the reason why I say that is not to be bragging, but it wasn't because of my skateboarding, but it's because I love skateboarding. And I used to go to the competitions, and I got to see all the best skateboarders, and I just loved it and appreciated it. And the point is, everybody wants to be the best, but you gotta be the best person you are, and more importantly than that, you gotta be happy. And if you go to them on the right things for the right reasons, you're gonna end up in the right place. This is about life, it's about skating. We all fall down, but you gotta get your ass back up. This is for the skaters, this is for the suicidal motherfuckers, this is for life. Full sense to skate! Get your fist up! Push us to sky!